Christmas is coming, or Hanukkah, or Festivus, or maybe you just have bad spending habits, which is why your main YouTube viewing is dumb product comparisons like this. So I thought I'd put together a list of recommendations on lights I have reviewed to help you find the right big lumen light you have to hide from your significant other or roommate who needs rent money. Some of these lights were released a few years ago, and some have been released this year. This isn't every single big lumen flashlight they ever made, just the ones I have reviewed, tested, and liked the best. 7,000 lumens with a good tint from 2 years ago is still better than 2,000 lumen light from this year with an ugly tint, right? That's how it works. So we'll divide it into three basic sections. Lights that have 3,000 to 10,000 lumen outputs. Yep. And then lights from 10,000 to 20,000 lumen outputs. And then lights above 20,000. Okay, on your mark, set, go. First up, 3,000 to 10,000 lumens. I get it, you're sort of on a budget. I'll give you three or four here. First, at about $60, the Convoy L6. It uses lithium-ion rechargeable 26650 batteries. It's big, it's bright, and has a dual-switch, easy-to-use interface. A hard on-off switch on its tail, and mode-changing on its side. So, this one gets you in the mid-3,000 lumen range, and it's built extremely well. It'll illuminate stuff a few hundred feet out very well. Check out my review of this light for full details. To do this, just easily search Advanced Knife Pro and Convoy L6 and it'll pop up. And of course, all the other lights, just my name and the product number. I'll also link them below the video in case you want to do it that way. Next up is a $50 to $70 light if you have a coupon code, the BLF Q8. It has a great neutral tint and a cool ramping feature, brightness adjustment. It's easy to use and runs off of four 18650 batteries. It's a versatile light that gives you choices from very dim to 5200 lumens. Its beam doesn't quite reach as far in the distance as the Convoy L6, but it's brighter. So it has a good high and the lowest low of all the big lumen lights here. And lastly in this section is the Noctigon Meteor at 7200 lumens. This light is awesome, but the user interface requires you to use shortcuts mostly. So if you hate reading quick operation manuals because you still can't read, maybe skip this light. The light is several years old now, but it's compact, extremely well engineered, and cool looking, if that's a descriptor that could be used unironically when describing a flashlight. But ironically works too. It's about $130. Okay, you know what? How about one more? The Storm of Ra. This light is a beast, and with the longest beam distance here, and it's super easy operation. It's not practical and not a rough and tumble light, meaning don't drop it, but it has active cooling and burns through batteries quickly. The coolest light really in the whole video, maybe other than the Noctigon Meteor, and it puts a smile on my face every time I whip it out. Now this one's $350, so not for ramen eaters, or maybe a ramen eater after you buy it. Now again, this video is an overview. Watch all of these reviews where I test the manufacturer lumen claims, the runtimes, and show you how they're used, and then make your decision. All right, 10,000 to 20,000 lumen range. Most people don't need lights this bright, and I'll pare it down to just two. First up is the TN36 2017 edition, which is just over 10,000 lumens, but I chose it because it has an easy-to-use user interface like the BLF Q8. It's a cool white tint only and only comes in a bundle with batteries and a charger. All lights in this video you'll need to buy a battery and charger separately for, except for this one. Well, there's another one too. It hasn't been shown yet. And it'll set you back $250. This is probably my least favorite light in the bunch though, because I like some of my less bright lights more, and this one comes in only a cool white tint, and I also have a lot of brighter lights now, so it kind of gets lost in the mix. Next is the 14,000 lumen Acebeam X45. Apparently this one also includes batteries, and I didn't research my own lights before I made a video about them. This is about a $240 light. It takes four 18650 batteries and comes in a neutral or cool tint. I reviewed the neutral, but it seems some people say the cool tint has a slight green cast to it. Should be a little brighter, but you know, that could be a consideration. I would go with the neutral if I were you, which is a touch on the warm side, just a touch. It's a substantial light, and 14,000 lumens lights up my whole large backyard brightly. Again, in these individual videos, you'll see the batteries I use to test these with. So this isn't a battery buying guide, it's a light buying guide. Now, I said I was only going to do two lights, but if you need a bit more throw and you want something in the 15,000-ish lumen range, which is more like 13,000, try the Imalent DT70, which I also reviewed, but it only comes in a cool tint and it's, of course, less bright than the Acebeam X45. And finally, the biggest lumen range, over 20,000 lumens. My favorite light is the Imalent DX80, which comes in over 30,000 lumens. There's actually only two or three lights in this whole category altogether, but this is my favorite of the two. This light is massive and it has a built-in battery. You can get it for about $380 or sometimes in the mid to high $200 range if you can find an online coupon. This is literally the current brightest factory-built verified lumens light you can buy as of November 2017, and I don't see one coming up in the next month or two that's gonna trounce it. It's an insane amount of light. Check out my review for that full beam shot comparison so you can see some of these other lights I've mentioned here. You're like, so what about the Acebeam X80? Well, it's about 10,000 lumens dimmer. It gets hot a lot faster and has gimmicky colored LEDs. I don't hate it, but I don't know, the Imalent's a better light. The Imalent has a button that's a little hard to find in the dark, so that's one negative thing about it that I don't know if I brought up in the review. For a light that puts out 20 to 30,000 lumens, you need a lot of aluminum to help dissipate all that heat generated by the LEDs. All right, so check out the description for links to reviews of these lights. Thanks for watching.